Hi class, today we're going to write a code on leap year testing. The program will be getting input from command line, which means that the user is giving the value of year at command line. At the same time, he gives the program name to be launched. We will see more about command line afterward. Why not we look at the definition of leap year first? Most of us only knows that leap year are years that can be divided by 4. That is partially correct because leap year not only the years that can be divided by 4, but it excludes the years that can be divided by 100. So for example, year 1900 is not a leap year, even though it can be divided by 4. But since it can be divided by 100, it is not leap year. But again, on the contrary of the second condition, the year is leap year if it can be divided by 400. So it can be seen here that year 2000 is a leap year, even though it can be divided by 100. But since it can be divided by 400, it is a leap year. So if the year cannot be divided by any of either 4, 100, or 400, it is, of course, not a leap year. This is the definition that you can find from the internet, from the document or the literature that define leap year. The definition by words will be started by the ability to divide by 4, then by 100, then by 400. But in our coding, we will start from bottom up, meaning we have to start with 400 first, meaning testing the divisibility by 400, then we test divisibility by 100, then divisibility by 4, not by 4 first, then 100, then 400, because if we do that, we will end up giving the result that year 1900 is a leap year because it can be divided by 4. So the logic is, why we start by testing for divisibility by 400 first is because the least number of years that can be divided by 400. Then more years can be divided by 100. Then more years can be divided by 400. So we start from the least number of years. That will ensure our logic is correct. Then let us look at the issue on command line parameter. In this program, we are not going to use scanf, but we want to use command line parameter. So in this case, command line parameter is actually an alternative to scanf. If we use scanf, we don't have to use command line parameter already because that will be redundant. Or if we use command line parameter, we don't have to use scanf anymore in most of the time. So this is how a command line parameter looks like. Let's say we name our program isLeap, then we want to immediately give the value or the year 1998 to be processed by our program. We straight away key in 1998 after at least a space after the program name. So this is what we call command line parameter. So in order to use command line parameter, you need to know two built-in variables. The first is argc, the second one is argv. Argc stands for argument count. The meaning of argument count is the number of token or the number of word that we issue at the command line when we invoke the program. In this case, we invoke first is isLeap, second is 1998. So in that case, argc will be 2. And argv stands for argument vector or array of argument, in this case array of string. And because it's array of string that we issue at the command line, obviously if argc is 2, then there will be only 2 elements in the array of argv. So we have argv0 to represent the name of the program that we are launching, and argv1 is the first parameter that comes after the program name. So let's say this is the way we issue out the program. Then, as an example, this program will write the output at a command prompt like this. 1998 is not a leap year. Let us write this program. Start your Win32 console application project on Visual Studio 2015. This is the auto-generated code. Just now, we say that in order to use command line parameter in our console program, we need to use ARGC and ARGV. So these two need to be declared first. The first one is integer. ARGC stands for argument count. Then the other one is ARGV. It is an array of string actually, but in C nomenclature, it is a parameter to char or character. Since we are using a mixture of C and C++ in this case, we are taking ARGV, which is an array to pointer to character, but we are going to process it as C++ string object because it is actually strings. So in that case, we have to modify our stdafx.h so that we can use string. How do we do that? We include string. Don't choose string.h listed in the IntelliSense because string.h is for C. We want C++ object, which is string only. That's it. We can save stdafx.h. Then we can straightaway close it. Then, in any command line parameter programming, we need to quickly grab our input that is given to us at command line. In this case, our input is the year, the value of year. When we grab the parameter are all in string form. So what we need to do is to keep them as string first. We need to put std to precede all string object declaration because we are not explicitly saying that we are using standard namespace. So we always have to put std colon colon in our declaration of string. So by putting that, we can see afterward string is listed in IntelliSense. If you don't put std colon colon, you cannot see string. So let us declare, let's say, a variable name year, but because we also want to use year for the integer form of year, we put str at the end of the year variable so that we can tell that this is a string variable. And then we quickly assign the variable to the string value of year. In this case, if you remember, it is argv index 1. Then we normally will also quickly convert the string to the value that we want. In this case, the year has to be integer, so we convert the string to integer. So we declare an integer, year integer. Now we convert again std colon colon. Then we can find string to integer stored there. Then what's the value that we want to convert? It is the string value of year, year str. Then we can straight away go to the logic, the business logic that we want to process on the numerical value of the year to tell whether it is a leap year or not. So it has to be if, because we want to test the value of year. So yes, if. And if what? If the year is divisible by 400 first. We have to test for the least number of year first. If the year is divisible by 400, meaning if year mode 400, this means the remainder when divided by 400. If year integer mode 400 equal to 0, so this condition is the condition that the year is divisible by 400. Meaning, when year integer divided by 400, the remainder is 0. Then we better put another pair of bracket there, because perhaps we are not so sure if the comparison will be done first before the mode operation. So if this is true, then what we do? We print that the year is a leap year. %D is leap year. And what to match with %D? It is year integer. We need to test for the next condition, which is the divisibility by 100. So it is a separate testing, but still in the same structure. So we need to put else if. And what condition do we want to test? The condition of divisibility by 100. So we can copy and paste, then change 400 to 100. And we print that it is not leap year. Then the last condition is divisibility by 4. It is a leap year. Then if the year cannot be divided by 400, 104, meaning it is not a leap year. So we put the last or default condition, else the year is not a leap year. That is it. Let us test this on command prompt. Launch the command prompt. Let us run this by issuing program name is leap. If you see this after you run your program, this is an indicator that you are missing the command line argument. Remember that this program is written to accept one command line argument, so we have to give that command line argument. Otherwise, it will crash like this. So if you see this, you know that you need to issue command line argument abort, then redo, and give the year as the command line argument that we set up in the program. So the output is 1998 is not leap year. Let us test for 1996, a leap year. 2016 is a leap year. What about 1900? Not leap year. What about 2000? Is a leap year. Now let us test the case if we test for the case of divisibility by 4 first. Meaning, to show if the sequence of testing here, does it matter or not? Let's test for divisibility by 4, then 100, then 400. It is correct for year 2016, but if we try for 1900, it says year 1900 is a leap year, which is wrong because year 1900 is not a leap year. So In this case, the sequence of testing of the divisibility is important. So let us restore the sequence of testing according to the previous sequence. That is it for this program.